because I said so. Have you ever heard that? Have you ever been told that or something similar to that? Well, I'm going to tell you why that kind of attitude can be disastrous in your training. Hi, I'm Tony Cecchini and welcome to the channel. You know, many people who study, especially grappling arts, tend to do things because they were told to do it. They don't really know the ins and outs of why. They only know that I'm supposed to do such and such when I'm in this position or during this time frame. And that's because my instructor told me so. Sometimes that's how the instructor learned, and he or she may not know all the intricacies of it. They may be just doing as they were told and passing that along to you. And while that works for many people, I think it drastically limits your creativity, which will ultimately lead to your improvisation, which will make you a far more dangerous fighter, more efficient, and a quicker submission specialist. To me, first and foremost, you must know the human anatomy and realize the potential limits to a limb. And conversely, you have to be able to take that limb beyond its limits. That's how you can injure somebody. Since most of you can't train with me physically, I would say this. Take a move that you're very fond of. Let's just say it's a straight armbar, a traditional jiu-jitsu armbar, and start learning it in a variety of angles and from a different approach. So what I mean by that is many of you can do this armbar like when you're laying flat on your back and the arm is between your legs, or when you're laying belly down. But there's a whole big clock. There's 360 degrees where you can attack that arm. And you need to understand, where do I put that fulcrum? Where do I get my leverage? Many times I'll see people gripping up double wide, let's say from here to here. And you're not getting the optimum leverage. I discuss this on some of my videos, but most importantly, you have to think of a pump handle, okay? You don't want a short pump handle. That's going to be very difficult to get that water out. You want a longer handle. Like Archimedes says, give me a lever and I'll move the world. Well, you know, that's the whole point of this. You need to understand that. And then you need to delve into a different avenue. Meaning, where do I get this submission from? You know, years ago I was training a rather advanced grappler, and he was shocked when he was seeing that I was able to get certain submissions that he knew, but from different positions. And it was because he was never shown that. And that's unfortunate, because you, again, have to be able to see submissions everywhere. So let's take the example of that straight armbar. You know, maybe try to do it when you're more in a fetal position on your hip, or maybe when you're laying a little bit awkwardly. Because awkwardness is the key to this. Let me explain what I mean. Many times when people injure themselves, now I'm not talking about in training, but just accidentally from a fall or something of that sort, they land awkwardly. It's not obvious that, you know, 100% of the time you're gonna land flat on your back or flat on your face. It's sometimes these awkwardness things that come into play. And most of people's training is not awkward. They do things very structured in a balanced, straight position. Well, it's this awkwardness that can really lead to injury, and that's a way that you need to start training. Now, when I say awkwardness, I don't mean carelessness. I mean just from an awkward position. And this is how you need to work out sometimes. As long as it's cooperative, you don't want to actually injure your opponent or your training partner in this matter. You want him or her to be able to tap out. So start experimenting. Instead of being flat on your back or belly down, for example, be on your side, be a little bit forward, be a little bit backwards, and then start developing your mind and saying, hey, how can I generate that fulcrum? How can I get that lever action that I need from these positions? I've said it before, one of the biggest reasons that I'm able to tap people quickly is because I work on the transition. I don't work from a static position. I actually want you moving, and then I can use your momentum against you, just like you would on the feet with a takedown or a throw, When you're on the ground and you move even slowly, that is momentum. And I want to manipulate that and lead you into that submission. It may be coming from a very awkward spot for you or for me, but it doesn't matter. When you know the principles of how to attack a limb, you can tap somebody out or break somebody and hook them from anywhere. Well, I just wanted to give you guys some food for thought. I really appreciate you coming to the channel. You know I'm always available at catchrussell.com. If you can, please hit that like and subscribe button and ring that bell so you can get notifications of new videos. I will see you soon, and thanks for watching.